Welcome back, and thanks for joining me, Phil Spencer, for this episode of my Insider's Guide to All Things Home Related. Today, I'm going to be sharing my top tips for how first-time buyers can own a home by the age of 25. If you are a first-time buyer, make sure that you visit the MoveIQ website, where you'll find all kinds of advice, guides, step-by-steps, and people who can help make your home-owning dream a reality. Just click the link below and get started. So, is home ownership in your mid-20s an impossibility? Well, there's no doubt that there are a number of obstacles, and first-time buyers have been hit hard by the impact of COVID-19. Many banks withdrew their riskier loans, where buyers only needed a 5 or 10% deposit. Exactly the kind of mortgage many would-be first-time buyers relied on. The stamp duty holiday undoubtedly injected some life back into the housing market, but that's not necessarily been an advantage if you're starting out. Property prices rose by 4.3% in 2020, and the average house price now sits at £224,000. However, first-time buyers don't pay stamp duty on properties under £300,000 anyway, so they lost their advantage during a time when competition in the market was hotting up. Those looking to buy a home are recommended to save as high a deposit as possible, 20% ideally, to help secure more manageable monthly payments and with lower interest rates. But if the average property price is £224,000, a 20% deposit means nearly £45,000. So how can it be done? It may sound obvious, but you need to save, and then save a little bit more. Start by setting a long-term goal and have a specific figure in mind. Let's suppose that you'd like to buy in 3 years' time and you need to save £20,000, then that's around £417 a month that you need to put aside. To do this, it's essential you know where every penny of your income goes. So sit down and take a good long look back at your bank statements and your credit cards to see what eats up your cash. Lifestyle switches like opting for supermarket-owned brands, cutting back on takeaway coffees and lunches, for example, soon add up as the days, weeks and months and even years go by. Luxuries such as holidays, indulgent clothes, expensive trainers, they may have to go. Of course, if you have a partner to buy with, that makes things easier. Two incomes mean you're not only able to save more, but have a higher combined income to offer to any mortgage lender. And well before you put yourself in front of any lender, do get prepared in advance. They'll look at your credit report, so check your credit score now. You can do that on the MoveIQ website. If it's poor, then you've got time to improve it. Make sure you pay your bills on time, pay off any existing debts, pay off your credit card bills each month, and make sure no fraudulent transactions are logged against your name. It may be worth talking to an independent financial advisor or a mortgage advisor who can help out and put you in the best position with potential lenders. Finally, don't forget that the government does have help available for first-time buyers. The Help to Buy Equity Loan Scheme allows you to purchase a new build property with a deposit as low as 5%. Alongside this, Boris Johnson has vowed to turn generation rent into generation buy in the form of a 95% mortgage guarantee scheme to help those with smaller deposits get on the ladder. The good news is that there are plenty of examples of people who have defied the apparent dismal stories and actually ended up buying on their own in their mid-20s. It is possible, but it does take a bit of hard work and preparation. I hope this episode's given you inspiration to start your home-owning journey. Do subscribe to the channel, as we have expert property advice uploaded regularly. I hope you'll join me again sometime soon.